Welcome to the HellermannTyton Academy, the workshop for the professional. You've been Googling how to install heat shrink products, and we're here today to show you how to do that, and in particular, how to use our V9500 epoxy adhesive. My name's Barry.
And I'm Mark.
And we're going to demonstrate the product to you. Not only do we say, we demonstrate. Right, Mark,
right,
what do
then.
We need to do?
Barry, can you pass me the applicator gun?
Here we go. So we need an applicator gun for this product?
So we do need an applicator gun for this product. What this enables us to do is to get the adhesive out of the tube.
Okay.
So this is a two-part epoxy adhesive.
So what do we mean by two-part epoxy?
So we have a hardener on one side and a resin on the other, and we have to mix them.
Okay.
So the way we do that is through a nozzle. So we take the end off. It's really, really easy to use.
So what's special about this nozzle?
So this nozzle allows both the hardener and the resin to mix. So when it comes out the end, it's already mixed.
So it goes in as two and comes out as one?
That's correct, yes, yes.
Perfect.
It's very precise to use as well.
Okay.
So where you want
How
to
precise is it?
Well, I can demonstrate that to you, Barry, actually. And it is a two-part epoxy. So what we mean by that, Barry, like we said in the beginning, we've got hardener on one side.
Yep.
And we have the resin in the other.
So this is a thermoset product then?
This is correct, yes.
And we mean by thermoset, when you heat it, it cures and becomes a solid. So that means it's impervious to a lot of aerospace, defence, chemicals and fluids.
Yes, and when it's actually applied, Barry, you can't remove it. Right, Barry, would you like to demonstrate how we'd use it on a cable?
Okay. So we need a heat shrink boot, which is supplied in a bag. We then need to prepare the cable, Mark.
Indeed, Barry. So what do we need to prepare the cable with?
We need our standard alcohol wipes, as usual, as you've seen in our other videos. If not, check out the link below.
So this is a standard procedure when applying heat shrink boots or heat shrink tubing, is to make sure that your cable is always nice and clean and there's no grease on it.
And as we have a back shell on the back of this one, we need to clean the back shell as well.
Okay, Barry.
Because that gets dirty. So we're ready.
Do we need to abrade the cable?
We do, yes. So we abrade as we've done before.
So again, we're abrading up and down, Barry.
Yes. So we prevent the cracking when you bend the cable for your test procedure at the end.
Why are we showing this tomorrow when it's set, Barry?
Because it takes 7 hours at room temperature. Right. Or you can speed that process up by baking it in an oven at 85 degrees.
Oh, right. I see. So we don't have to wait seven hours then. We can actually speed this up.
Yeah. Yes. If you're in a production situation or environment, then you could do that. So, right, we're prepared.
Okay, do we have to prepare the heat shrink bits?
We
as
do,
well, Barry?
We follow the same process. So, again, we abrade like so. We're ready. So, a dry wipe.
Yep. And this is the dry wiping is to get rid of all this dust.
Correct, yep. We want to get rid of the debris.
Be sitting on the cable. So we don't want that dust underneath the
That's right.
adhesive.
So we have a prepared cable, prepared boot.
Brilliant.
We're ready.
Right, Barry, I've already
shown how easy it is to use. So we apply the adhesive to the inside edge.
So it's only the inside edges, Barry. It's
yes.
not all the way through, yeah?
Because it bonds so well,
yeah.
You only need a seal at either end. It becomes an integral part of the cable harness. Okay?
Okay, that's good.
Then
so
we can,
what's the operating temperature of this, Barry?
It's -55 to 150, plus 150, but we have tested it for the SAE spec at over 200 degrees.
And there's no detriment to
No detrimental effect to the product. So we also then apply it to the connector.
So what part of the connector are you putting that adhesive onto?
So as a connector is built, it has the back shell entry where it connects to the connector. Then we have a spring, this is a spring band adapter, so it has a spring band to allow you to fix the braid on. So you get EMI continuity from end to end.
I see, yeah.
And then there's a groove that's designed into the back shell to take the lip of the boot.
But how do you know which side's got the lip on the boot?
So the product has a H and a J marking, so you can understand which way it goes on, because otherwise you could put it on upside down.
Oh, right, okay.
Okay, and we'll explain that. We have another video which is showing that
Let's
later.
Show that, okay.
Okay, so we're ready.
So again,
protective wear, yeah. Because we're using heat guns.
So what's the heat gun set to this time, Barry?
If it's one of the HellermannTyton style like this, it's set to 7.
Yeah.
That 7 means it's in the region of 225 to 250 degrees.
Okay. Do we need a special nozzle on the end of it, Barry?
We do, yes. For this allows us to do precise work similar to the nozzle we have on here.
Okay.
Like so. And we're ready to go. Now, the adhesive actually kicks off at around about 90 degrees.
Right.
What I mean by kick off, it will start to cure.
Yeah.
So anything above that is a good point to be at, because we know it's going to cure. So our temperature for the heat shrink product is around about 135.
Right.
So we're in a good position.
Just before we start that, Barry, what happens to this now?
So if you're doing numerous applications,
yeah,
you can carry on using it.
Yeah.
If you're not, then you can remove the nozzle. So once you've refitted it, you can actually put it in the fridge and it will suspend the curing process, ready for use tomorrow.
So that would be okay,
yep,
for use tomorrow. What's the shelf life of this product, Barry?
The shelf life is 18 months and we guarantee that we will sell it out with at least 80% of its cure life still valid.
Oh, right, okay.
So we turn over the stock
so
regularly.
So if we're using lots of it, then yep, it wouldn't really matter.
No.
Because you'd use it all, yeah?
And we can supply it to you in bulk if you require it in larger tins.
Oh, right, okay.
For dosing units. Okay, answered your questions?
Yes.
Right, well, let's get cracking and shrink this product on. So we supply over the top.
Yeah.
Ready to fit. So we recover the lip end.
What's the lip end called again?
The H end.
The H end, yeah. So why do we start at this end?
Because this is the fixed point. So once it's located, we know that the boot that's recovering further down is in the right position.
Right, okay.
So with this precise nozzle, it allows us to shrink quickly.
Yeah. So I can see there now, but it's actually going into the groove on
Correct.
The connector. And there's actually a lip inside that boot that says that actually goes into that groove.
So it's
now
located in the groove. Is it recovered on the other side or what, Mark?
Yeah. So there's lots of adhesive coming out.
Yeah, don't worry about that. That's a good thing.
Can we wipe some of that off? Just to neaten it off.
Okay, so when we get to this point, you pass me the alcohol wipe.
The alcohol wipe, Barry, yeah?
Yep.
Alcohol wipe.
What we can do is remove like so.
Can you? Because we've got a small amount there on the connector.
Yep, we'll do the same. And then we can remove it from the connector as well. Like so. We just finish it off.
Yep.
So what will happen? We now have a witness line.
So by the witness line, do you mean this where I can see the adhesive that's gone all the way around?
Correct. You have a visible bond. You can tell the adhesive has flowed.
Right, okay.
So there we go. So that's now ready to be left to cure, or we can put it in the oven overnight, for 2 hours, and then it will cure in that time at 85 degrees.
So this could be ready to go in 2 hours?
Yes.
Or you can stay overnight, yeah?
Correct. Like so. And here's one I prepared earlier. So you can see we've got the bond. It's a perfect fit.
Right.
And while it's in this state now, it's set.
Yeah.
We can do our standard bend test around a standard.
So the standard bend test is to make sure it doesn't crack at the joint.
So the diameter of this is 6 times the cable. So you pick the right size for your cable. Right. You just hold and bend.
So it's important actually to see that flow of adhesive round to make sure that when you do your bend test, there's no cracks. Brilliant.
Perfect.
Really good.
Another excellent job.
Excellent.
Okay, Mark, we don't just promise, we prove. No, Mark, we prove. Perfect. So, if you liked our little demonstration, please like us and subscribe to our channel. I'm Barry.
And I'm Mark.
And we'll see you again soon.
Bye.